She was glad that little Renee had at least had her new friend for comfort during those long, scary hours alone in the bush. The family were just alighting from the vehicle. Mrs. Haywood was firmly holding Renee's hand. Sarah had a feeling it would be a long time before she felt easy about letting go. The icy cold, well-groomed and fashionable blonde of a few days ago was nowhere to be seen. Mrs. Haywood wore no makeup, and her hair was caught in a ponytail. She laughed as she bent over to listen to something her daughter said. She and her husband shared a look, and both smiled. Sarah wondered if maybe some good had come from all that trauma, after all. Seeing Sarah in the door of the store, the Haywoods crossed the road. "Good morning," she said as they approached. "It's good to see Renee looking so well." The little girl looked up at hearing her name. The scratches on her face were healing, as was her sunburnt skin. Her brother was standing very close to her. Obviously, the guilt Dustin felt at losing her was still fresh in his mind. She could only hope that time would heal him as it healed his sister. "Hello," Evan Haywood replied. "You're Sarah, aren't you?"
"Yes."
"You were out there with the searchers. I remember seeing you."
"I was," she said.
"Thank you," Mrs. Haywood said. "If you and all the others hadn't been there to help."
"Don't think about that," Sarah said kindly. "There were a lot of people out there. We had all the thanks we needed when we saw Tia and Pete carry Renee into the camp."
"Is Pete here?"
the boy asked.
"No,"
she said, trying to keep her heartache out of her voice.
"He's off somewhere delivering a big load in his truck. I wanted to say goodbye."
"I'll tell him goodbye from you when I see him."
Sarah wondered if she would ever get the chance to keep her promise.